Guard and temporary shelters are full. But in this darkened, ravaged city, people do their best.
Within, say, like 300 or 400 meters from the shorefront, in a scene of chaos. It's cold, it's dark, there's no power anywhere. And yet, up there, in that abandoned block of flats, on the top floor, there's one light. One man, one family, perhaps, trying to survive.
The following day, on the main road back to Tokyo, the artery that connects north and south is empty. A reminder that this country has ground to a halt.
One of the worst nuclear accidents in history is stopped right now. And we're dealing with multiple meltdowns on the shore.
Two radioactive substances, cesium and iodine, were detected near the number one reactor at the plant on Saturday.
The Fukushima nuclear base is about 60 kilometers that way. That's about 38 miles or so, I think. We've got the windows closed. We're driving fast. The advice is very conflicting. The American government says that we could be cleaned around 80 kilometers. And of course, we're well within that. On the other hand, the Japanese government is saying, fine, as long as we're 7 kilometers away. So, I mean, it's going to be south. But I think the window's closed, and I'll put on a map. Let's do that.
At Fukushima Power Plant, the nuclear crisis worsens. The emergency batteries are dead. There is no power to cool the reactor. Temperatures quickly rise. Water levels drop. Pressure builds. The incredible heat of the fuel rod generates hydrogen gas. The hydrogen explodes. Desperate plant workers inject seawater into the reactors in an effort to cool them. Essentially, those plant operators at the time said, we're going to commit plant suicide. We're going to go ahead and kill these plants, knowing that they'll never work again. But that was a better option than not letting the cooling system fail and reaching even a worse outcome.
There's been another blast at a tripping Japanese nuclear power plant. The second hydrogen exploded in 3 days.
The Japanese military used helicopters to scoop up seawater to dump on the reactors. It doesn't work. The long-term consequence of what is happening at Fukushima remains unknown. The humanitarian disaster continues. Estimates put the death toll from the quake and tsunami at over 20,000. For scientists, the analysis goes on. From all the data they have acquired, one threat is still very real. For years, experts have warned of a large quake and tsunami off the coast near Tokyo. Japan's recent disaster happened 260 miles north. But now, the fault lines below Tokyo are even more stressed.
What's the inspection is set up the Philippine plate relative to the Eurasian plate. What's actually occurred is split of the Pacific plate relative to the Eurasian plate. Sometimes a great earthquake will cause the next patch of the plate boundary to slip. So all eyes on what's happening, how this earthquake will stress the neighboring part of the plate boundary. You've got to understand, this whole region is in a very high-stakes threat, ready to go, and they can be expected to go in a minute. So this recent earthquake is going to pull that closer. The question is how much.
When an earthquake like this happens, it
major industrial economies on the planet. That part of the Pacific Rim is not the place you would choose.
It could be happening as we speak, or it might have happened today.
The critical thing is, has this particular earthquake shaped the map and used it up so that it brings forward the timing of that earthquake?
The tourist agenda that we can stop from that sort of phenomenon. What we've got to do is to learn to live with it and minimize the consequences when they happen, and minimize also the recovery time.
It's very difficult for science to protect against earthquakes and tsunamis. What science can do is help town planners, engineers, to make buildings stronger, to make designed buildings and cities more resilient. We cannot stop these things happening. We can't prevent it. We can prepare for it.
Scientists believe Japan's tsunami holds valuable lessons for the U.S.
One of the interesting things about this earthquake is that it's really a template for what might occur on the northern coast of Oregon and Washington. We know we are expecting an almost identical size earthquake.
Stretching from Vancouver Island to northern California is Cascadia, a vast and volatile fault line. Here, like Japan, one plate is driving beneath another, squeezing and compressing. Tremendous pressure builds. Cascadia could rupture in a huge magnitude 9 quake. A megaquake off the Pacific Northwest coast would create a tsunami similar to Japan. Roger Billums scans the coast of Japan for clues. He hopes to understand what could happen to America's west coast.
Like this coastline is long and